Hunter?
Okay, I'll question.
Yes?
So, 11.
11.
I got 26.9 points.
That's fine. The reason we got different answers is because you probably used 3.14 for pi.
Yeah.
I used more digits of pi than just. I use whatever my calculator has stored as pi, which is several decimal places. If you look at this, it's that many digits. So if I use that as pi, sometimes you'll get a slightly different answer. But if you use 3.14, that's fine with me. Mm-hmm. Question.
You got 7 wrong.
7 wrong, so we'll go over that. Another number? Hold on.
2, I got 1.
2, you got 1. A lot of people did. Show.
I got
1. Okay, we got 1. Marcus?
11.
11. See 11 all the way through. Brandon again?
I got. Wait, 4 wrong?
4.
Definitely. You can do the whole thing.
9. You can do the whole thing, it's just your time, Maddie.
10.
10.
I've
done
the whole thing. Well, I did a question of effort this time, so.
Well, I won't be here for lunch. Okay. I have to go grab some lunch from somewhere else. You'll have to, I mean, you can, here's the deal. You can retake them, right? So you can give it a shot today.
Okay.
Just like anybody else can do it today, and then if you want to retake it, you retake it. If you really feel like you need to study up on it before you even try the first time, you can do that while everybody else is taking it.
Okay.
With retakes, it's kind of a moot point. But to make it up, you need to just organize with me, like, when you can come in.
With the slips.
That'd be a perfect way to do it. That would be easy. If something else needs to, like, if a lunchtime needs to be when you come in, then we'll have to arrange it otherwise.
Okay.
Yes.
Number 5.
5. Okay, we're doing a lot of them, which means we need to be efficient with our time, all right? So here we go. Number 1. 72 divided by 3 times 6 plus 2. We're just going to follow that order of operations that we all agreed we would follow. So what comes first, Colby?
6 plus 2.
So that's going to give us 8 in the parentheses.
And then 72 divided by 3.
Right. The thing that you might have done mistakenly was 3 times 8 first. Okay? It looks nice and tidy, and 3 times 8, it looks like a nice little chunk of problems, so you just go ahead and multiply it together, but remember that we said we would do multiplication and division in order from left to right. Left to right, aren't you?
But
parentheses first means inside of parentheses. Okay? And that we did do parentheses first. Now it's just, I could take the parentheses away and say 3 times 8. Okay, I can see where that could be confusing. When parentheses is just telling you to multiply something together, it's not what parentheses means. Parentheses means stuff inside. Okay, so good question. So 24 times 8 is 192. It's almost 25 times 8, so it would be 200, but it's 8 less than that. Number 2, okay? Probably you're having the same issue with this one. We have 5 times 4 divided by 10 times 2. We got multiplication and division only, right? I bet everybody did 5 times 4 is 20. Divided by 10 times 2. If you got 1, it's because you did 10 times 2 before you did 20 divided by 10. Right? Multiplication and division at the same time, right? With the same preference, okay? But from left to right. Since division shows up first on the left, we do that first. 20 divided by 10 is 2, times this 2 is 4. Okay? Questions? Yes?
I have a question on
1.
How do you
make
10
to 7? Well, I might have done that wrong. I'm pretty sure 72 divided by 3 is 24. What do you get when you say
3? Oh, okay.
72 divided by 3 is 24. All right. Going on to number 4, unless someone stops me. Okay? We have 7 plus 11 times 5 minus 14 divided by 2. So we're going to do there's no parentheses, there's no exponents. So we're down to multiplication and division. Here's some multiplication, and here is some division. So we're going to point up with 7 plus 11 times 5 is 55. Minus 14 divided by 2 is 7, and it's a minus 7. I can see if I add 7 and 55 and then take 7 away, I'll just wind up with 55. Next, unless someone stops me from that. Question? All right, so. What's that? We'll get there. Number 5. Exponent is first, 5 squared, right? So 8 times 25. Minus 8. 8 times 25 is 200, minus 8 is 192. We multiply first, and then subtract, we get 192. All right. Next, adding fractions. 5 sixths plus 3 fourths. We can't add sixths to fourths because they're different. They're different sizes. Right? So we make them the same size, otherwise no one is finding a common denominator. Colby?
It'd be 12.
We have a common denominator of 12. Multiply this by 2, multiply this by 3. Right? Do the same thing in the numerator and denominator. So times 2 over 2, times 3 over 3. 10 twelfths plus 9 twelfths, 19 twelfths, or 1 and 7 twelfths. A question there?
No.
All good?
No, I'm just
tired. Okay. Fair enough. Okay, so last three of the area ones. Ready to go on to those?
Yes.
This is going great. You guys are gonna have lots of time.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we're almost done here. Should have plenty of time to get this done. Alright. So if I'm someone who remembers the formula, great. Use the formula. I'll find the area of the trapezoid. If I've forgotten the area of the formula for the area of the trapezoid, I'm okay because we learned in Mr. Stewart's class how to make up the formula for ourselves. Okay? How do we do that? Hunter.
You make a copy of the trapezoid.
Yeah.
Then you put it left or right, and then you put it upside down, like.
Right.
Make a copy.
Make a copy.
Turn it upside down.
Turn it upside down.
But then put it left. On top of the trapezoid, on top, yeah.
I'll flip a copy over and I'll put it right here.
Yeah. Four. And then you cut off like the left side or right side.
Either way.
Put it on the other side. And then you do 7 plus 9.
13. Oh, sorry. I cut that off in the picture. Yeah, so this is a copy. So this long side here is also 13 because it's just exactly the same as this.
Yeah.
So 7. Well, first, what shape is this?
A rectangle.
Yes. The area of a rectangle is simply?
Base down type.
Right. So you're finding the base now, right, Hunter?
Yes.
7 plus 13 is the base?
Yes.
Which is 20. Then what do you do with that 20?
Times 9.
Times 9, base times height?
Yeah.
Why are we dividing by 2?
Because there's two shapes.
There's two of the exact same shape. We only want the area of one, right?
Yeah.
7 plus 13 is, times 9, is the area of two trapezoids. So we divide by 2. We get
180.
We get 180 up here. Divide by 2.
90.
90.
Oh. Oh.
90 squared, right?
Squares.
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 Not squared. Squares. 4 units squared. If you really, really, really want to use that tiny 2. Yes.
Question, like, if you have a common denominator,
do
you have to be able to add and subtract
the
times divide, or
would
you
not use
common denominator?
Common denominator when you add and subtract. Okay. The reason for that is the common denominator, through from our discussion of what a fraction is, mm-hmm. right? The denominator is how big the pieces are, how many pieces it takes to make the whole, right?
Yeah.
So if I'm talking about like a 12th, I'm talking about that's a reflection of how big that piece is. Now, if I try to add that 12th to a 17th, they're two completely different things, like apples and oranges. We can't add a 17th and a 12th. They're not the same. So when you make the denominator is common, we're making the shape of the piece the same size. So we're adding together the same thing. Multiply fractions, we do not need a common denominator because it just doesn't matter if they're the same size or not. Okay. The new pieces are going to be completely different size from what we have with you, right? I'll get to that after I pass out the tests, all right?
What?
Once I pass out the tests, I'll get to that.
I can read.
I'll sign that when we pass out all the tests. That.
I don't know what you said. I need this sign so I can get a hearing aid battery for my hearing aid.
Oh. All right. Okay, next. We've got a thing with the thing missing.
Dun, dun, dun.
There's two shapes here. What's this shape?
Rectangle.
What's this shape?
Square.
Square, which is a rectangle, a special kind of a rectangle, right? So, can I find the area of both of these?
Yes.
Okay, let's say I have the area of the big rectangle, and I also know the area of the small rectangle, the square. What can I do with those two areas to figure out? No, not how to find the area, but if I knew the areas, how would I find the area of just the shaded part? What's that? You're telling me how to find the area. I'm saying that we know this area, and we know the area of this little square. How will I figure out what the shaded area is?
You subtract the little square from the big.
Take the little square out of the big square. You'll have just the shaded part left. Okay, so now it's all about what is the area of the big rectangle. 50. 10 by 5, right? How many squares can fit in this big rectangle?
50
can fit in there, because this is 10 by 5. All right, what's the area of this guy?
9
is 3 by 3. We can fit 50 squares there, but we are missing 9 squares, the 9 squares that would fit in this square.
41.
So we have 41.
Well,
now, this next one is the same basic idea. We have a shape, a big shape, with shapes missing.
Weird.
A big shape, we've taken some shapes out. We have a bunch of squares, and we took some squares away. Okay? So we can take the area of the trapezoid, subtract the area of the circle, and also subtract that little rectangle. Okay. Let's start with the rectangle. What's the area of that rectangle?
3.
It's 3 by 1, so 3 squares fit. How do we find the area of this circle?
Pi r squared.
Pi r squared. These squares, right? The square means they're made of squares. That's why there's a square there. That's why we square things. Okay. So that r squared can remind you that's about area, because area is about squares, right? So pi r squared. That's a little bit involved. Pi times r. What's r?
2.
2
squared. Radius is 2. So we have 4 pi. So Hunter brought this up earlier. You can use 3.14. I always use like a longer approximation of pi. All right. But if your calculator doesn't have a pi button, just use 3.14. If it does have a pi button, you should get in the habit of using that pi button. Okay. So take a look on your calculator. My calculators have a pi button. Okay. If you have a scientific, it probably does. So 4 times pi, I think it comes out to be like 12.56. That seems right. So this has an area of 3, this has an area of 12.56. Now I have to find the area of this trapezoid. We could do exactly as Hunter showed us, make a copy, flip it over, move the triangle, all that kind of stuff. Or you may remember that we just have to add this base to this base, base 1 plus base 2. Times the height, which is 5. I guess times the height, if we're going to use variables here, and divide by 2. So how long is the short side?
6.
Six. Plus, how long is this down here?
11.
All the way across the bottom, here?
11.
11. 5. 3. And another 3, 11. 6 plus 11 times?
4.
5.
The height of 5. Over 2. Base 1 plus base 2 times the height over 2. Or take the trapezoid and you do that whole copy and flip and make a rectangle out of it, you do the exact same thing. So 6 plus 11 is 17, times 5 over 2, that's 85, over 2, that's 42.5. So 42.5 minus 12.6 minus 3 is 26.93. Well, I guess it would be 26.94 if you use 12.56. How do I get that? I got that from the area of the circle, pi r squared. 2 squared is 4. 4 times pi. 12.56. Well, that's the area of the circle. So this is the area of the trapezoid, which is 42.5, minus the area of the circle, minus the area of that little rectangle. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Take the circle's area away, take the rectangle's area away. Right. Ready to go? Is everybody as ready as Hallie is?
Yep.
Thumbs up, amount of ready. Okay, two thumbs up, Mr. Hick is giving.